My name is Beatrice Gakuba. I'm the Executive Director of Africa Women in Agribusiness, in short, AWAN Africa. It is the network that is working for women and youth to promote them in agribusiness. Agribusiness is for those who have decided to make agriculture a business. And this is what we are not only promoting, but we are supporting, and we intentionally focus on women, because without promoting and empowering a woman, there will be no growth in agriculture on the continent. If you look at, for instance, us in AWAN Africa, what we're trying to help the women with is accessing to our finance. Most of the women grow, they have their business, but they can't grow their business just because they don't understand where to go to the to get finance. And when they go there, they ask them for collateral, they don't have, because collateral is with the husband or with you in the family. So that's access to finance is a challenge. Just because you're a mere fact of being, you are born a woman, It is already a handicap, so we have to address those and close the gap on that one. And the second one, having to access to market, is also mindset. Women will grow something, and who's going to trade that? The husband, the brother, in the rural areas. Women will not, very few, they go to the market, but for small things. But when it starts growing to make it a tangible business, it's taken over by the men surrounding that woman. So she doesn't derive the benefit of it. Even the family doesn't benefit that much. So in Africa, this is something that we're trying to challenge, that even access to market. So the young generation, with the knowledge and the skills, they'll be able to redress that challenges. So it's also an opportunity to see that young people now can take that value chain of market and trade to that. If you take an example of women trading cross-border, there's a lot of harassment there, and we all know that. There's a lot of harassment. The harassment is different when it comes to a man than to a woman. I don't have to go into the details, but we all know that. So this is a hindrance, you know. We can't, in 21st century, we cannot deal with that. So we're trying to sensitize those, you know, working with the service that deals with that, to be able to train also our officers to understand that, yes, you know, they have a right. You have to look at a girl and the woman in a different way. So in terms of technology, also access to there's a digital gap. Anything that comes with what is technology, everything, it goes first to the men and the family and the boys, and not to the women. We cannot grow a continent when we are ignoring constantly 50% of the population. Actually, 40% of our members are young people under 35 years old. So it is becoming appealing. Technology is making it appealing. Mobile phones and applications, and the way Africa actually is moving, it's something that's encouraging. And I was seeing more and more young people coming into agriculture. And also the fact that we are creating a new Africa Free Trade Area, we are telling them that actually the challenge is no longer market, is how you enter that market. So we are collaborating along the continent. The continent is going forward, is becoming robust. You know, we have to commend actually our people. You know, we criticize them a lot, our leaders, but you know, we have also to recommend and to recognize that they have, you know, created the enabling environment, or where we are operating in, it's not what it was 10 years ago. And the voice of citizens being heard. So it's now up to us. What are we doing for our own continent? We cannot sit and wait for our leaders, and we take them responsible. What are we us doing for that? And I think what will happen to our youth, and what will change Africa, is how we citizens are going to take forward what is offered by this African Union. Is stronger than it was 10 years ago. And we have a framework, we have an organization, we have a lot of things, but it also takes all of us Africans to understand that the future, our future, is in our hands. We cannot expect other people to come and do things for us.